Hi, this is Jacob with Cable Wholesale. Whether you've been making Ethernet cables for a while, a complete beginner, or maybe somewhere in between, we're going to show you 5 easy steps to making a perfect patch cable. The patch cables we are making have a plastic connector on the end. It is called an RJ45 connector. It looks like a telephone jack, but it's a little bit bigger. It has 8 copper contacts instead of the 4 or 6 that are on other phone cables. Traditional style crimp connectors are terminated by putting the pairs into the crimp's corresponding slots in the correct color code. Now, this style can be a little difficult and time consuming. What we are showing you today is the EZ-RJ45 connector. The difference is that the wires pass all the way through the crimp connector head. This makes it easier to know that our wires are in the correct color code and position within the crimp. It will help you terminate like a pro because you can get the connector further down on the twists, leaving less room for error while optimizing the performance. The first thing we will need to do is prep our cable. Here we are using our popular blue bulk Cat5e cable. The first step is to trim back the outer jacket 1 inch or 2. For that, we can use a regular razor blade. Now, with the sharp razor blade and gentle pressure, score the outer jacket, making sure that you do not nick the inner cables. Now that the inner conductors are exposed, we need to untwist the 4 pairs, getting them ready to align in their proper color code. Now, step 2 in making our patch cable is making sure that the inner conductors are lined up in the industry standard 568B color code. Now, that color code specifies this order: orange stripe, orange, green stripe, blue, blue stripe, green, brown stripe, brown. Now, this will be inserted into the connector from left to right. Now, we can move on to step 3. With our cables lined up in the correct color code sequence, orientation is going to be important here. We need to make sure that the tab on the connector is facing down. Now we can simply just feed the wires through the connector. With the wires inserted through the head of the RJ45, we are now ready to crimp and trim the excess wires. Cable Wholesale carries a tool specifically designed to work alongside these connectors. The tool features a blade at the end that will crimp and cut all in one motion. A traditional crimp tool will work, however, you will just need to trim the excess wire yourself. The last thing to do in our 5 easy steps is to test the cable to make sure it's ready for use. Cable Wholesale offers many different styles of testers, but for our purposes, we are going to utilize a simple continuity tester. This test will ensure that the signal is carried all the way through the cable. It looks like a job well done. All of the pairs are properly seated within the contacts. And there you have it. Those are the 5 easy steps that you need to take to make your very own Ethernet patch cable. I hope you guys found this informative and helpful, and if you did, please give us a thumbs up. If you have any suggestions for future videos you might like to see, leave us a comment. Don't forget to subscribe as well to make sure that you don't miss any future videos. For a list of all of the parts that we used today, check out the description below. Thanks for watching.